The first decision you're greeted with when you go to Apple Search Ads is basic or advanced. The short of it is, do advanced, don't do basic. But let me explain it real quick. For basic, all you do is give Apple a budget, say $1,000, say here's the most I'm willing to spend for install. Do your thing, Apple, go. I don't wanna know anything. I don't wanna know what keywords you're going after. I don't wanna know where you're putting my ads. You handle it, Apple. Now, for most indie devs, money is tight, and we wanna be very efficient and calculated with our money. So we wanna target specific keywords. Now, I guess if money was of no concern and you have a wide audience for your app, maybe it's like a habit tracker, personal finance, something that like everyone can use, and you just don't wanna be bothered with the time to mess with Apple Search Ads, sure, throw money at basic, call it a day. But the vast majority of you probably shouldn't do that. You should do advanced, where you can see where your money's going, you have more control over what keywords you're targeting. And to be honest, advanced isn't really all that advanced.
Today's video is sponsored by Glassfy.
One quick thing about basic is that you do get a $100 promo free for Apple for trying it. So you might as well throw a $100 budget at it and see what happens. It's actually what I did when setting up this video. I was like, oh, hey, I got 100 bucks. Why not? With an advanced campaign, you have full control. You get to target where your ads show up, whether it's on the Today tab, the search results. You can target specific keywords with exact match or broad match. You're just in full control, and you get a dashboard like this so you can see which keywords are doing well, which keywords aren't. Again, it's a no-brainer. Before I show you how to set up an advanced search result campaign, and before you start spending money on Apple Search Ads, I have two tips for you. The first is make sure your App Store marketing page and App Store screenshots are in a good spot. And same thing with the first-time user experience in your app or the onboard flow. I'm not saying they have to be perfect, but make sure they're at least decent. Because remember, you're spending money funneling people into your app, and you're making that first impression either on your App Store page or the first time they download it. So make sure that's in a good spot before you start throwing money at it. Here we are, searchads.apple.com. If you hit sign in, like I said before, you get the choice basic or advanced. Of course, we're gonna go advanced. This takes you to the authentication page. This is your Apple ID with your developer account, all that stuff. Go ahead and sign in. I'm gonna block off my stuff so you don't see that. When you sign in, you may see a different screen. These are my existing campaigns, but you wanna find the button that says create campaign, because we're gonna create a brand new ad campaign. Here you go, you're gonna choose an app. Of course, I'm gonna type in creator view, my app. You would type in your app. Now it says select where your ads will run, and there's four options here, right? We have the Today tab, the Search tab, Search results, or Product pages. We're gonna do a Search results, but for your knowledge, let's talk about each of these other ones real quick. So the Today tab, if I hit see an example, it is on the Today tab. As soon as someone opens up the App Store, boom, that's what they see. Now, as you can imagine, it's probably pretty competitive ad placement. People want that, so it's probably gonna be more expensive. And, you know, if it's on the home feed for everyone, you're not really targeting anything. So you probably want a very generic app, like a travel app, or maybe like a habit tracker app. So if you do have a very like niche app, like it's for people with YouTube channels, I probably don't want the Today tab. So make that decision for yourself. Now for the Search tab, if I hit see example, you see there it is. It's when they first hit the search screen, right? They haven't typed in a search term yet, but they're in the App Store about to search for something. So again, I would only go here if you have a very wide audience type app. Creator View is not that app, so I don't want to use it, but hey, it might be right for you if you want a wide, you know, audience seeing your app. And then product pages, hits the example. So you see, this is someone else's product page, scrolling all the way down to the bottom into the suggested, right? You might also like. So at least this is contextual, but still you're on someone else's product page and someone has to scroll all the way down to the bottom. Again, maybe it's right for you, but I think the no-brainer, the bread and butter, what we're gonna talk about today is by far the search results. So if I hit see example of this, you know, you see they search for a term, travel, come on, hurry up GIF. And then you see you show up at the top of the search results for specific keywords. So like I said, this is the bread and butter. This is what you want to use, but I wanted to explain the other variations in case, hey, maybe you have a use case where that works. So let's go ahead and click on search results. For a country, I'm just going to do the United States. Again, do whatever country or countries are applicable to you. Hit continue. So here we are for Creator View, search results in the United States, and then now you need to name your campaign. Now, if you're gonna run a bunch of different campaigns, maybe a bunch of different experiments, I would get highly, highly specific with this campaign name. For example, my campaign, I did like April of 2023 YouTube subscribers, because I was targeting that keyword with a custom product page. So I was very specific about when it was, you know, what I was targeting. You know, if you're doing various countries, maybe specify the country. So again, get very specific if you're gonna do a lot of campaigns. If you're only gonna do a couple, it can be a little more generic. So I'll name this, you know, YouTube video test. So daily budget, this is how much you want to spend. Now, I like to think of things in terms of monthly. So if you wanted to spend $1,000 a month or $500 a month, you know, divide that by 30 or 31, whatever you want to do, and come up with a daily budget. I usually do 40 because I target a little over $1,000 a month. But again, this is how much you want to spend. Now, negative keywords. This is optional. You don't have to do this. I do this because CreatorView, again, is an app for people with YouTube channels and running a YouTube business. So it's very YouTube focused, but I don't want to get confused with people searching for YouTube and they just want to watch videos. You know, I don't want to show up and waste my money on those people, right? So I have YouTube as a negative keyword. So to do that, you do YouTube. Now I'm going to add that, and you see match type broad versus exact. So broad will use keywords that are kind of similar or, you know, in the same vein, whereas exact, you hit do that and you get the brackets around it. That means no, they have to type exactly YouTube. And I want exact because I still want keywords like YouTube channel analytics, YouTube subscribers. Like I want keywords with YouTube in it, but I just don't want to show up for the keyword only YouTube. Now that's me, kind of a unique take. Maybe you don't have an app where you have negative keywords, so you don't have to add these. But again, think about things you don't want to show up for. And if it's very specific, make sure you do exact match. And then down here we have start and end date. So you wanna start today. End date is optional. You could have this run at $40 a day forever if you just have endless money. Most likely you wanna put an end date on here. Like I'll do, you know, let's say we wanna run it for a month. So we'll go to May 26th. I like to put an end date on mine and told you how many days are left, just because typically I'm running experiments, right? I wanna gather data on this experiment, analyze the data, get my learnings and knowledge from, you know, my cost per taps, my cost per acquisitions, which keywords are doing good, which keywords are doing bad. Take all that data and then wrap that up into my next experiment, right? You're constantly iterating to try and improve and optimize this. So that's why I would always put an end date on your campaign so you can assess them. Now an ad group, you can have different groups within the same campaign. I normally don't do that. So I just name this, you know, the same YouTube test. And then default max CPT bid. So this is, CPT is cost per tap. So that is how you pay on Apple search ads. When your ad shows up, if someone taps it, you paid. Whether they install it or not, that's when you pay. So suggested, this has never been accurate for me. Like I've had to pay like $2, $3, $4, $5 per tap typically. So 70 cents, I never got any impressions, never got any taps, never anything. So in my opinion, there's two ways to find out your number. And one is cheaper and one is faster. So the faster version is to just throw a high max cost per tap. So I did like $15, right? Just because I'll be the highest bidder. You probably won't pay $15. Of course, I shouldn't say that. It really depends on your niche. For me, again, I ended up paying like $2, $3, $4 cost per tap on average. So I didn't end up paying 15, but by being the highest bidder, I kind of found the max, if that makes sense. So that's how you can find your max quicker and then you can optimize from there. Or if you want to go the cheaper route, you know, start at the suggested 70 cents, see how it goes for a couple days. If you're not getting impressions or taps, hey, bump it up to $1.50, test it out for a couple days, right? You're slowly eking up to find that point. Whereas the faster way is you just throw a super high number in there, knowing that you're gonna spend, you know, $500, $1,000, whatever, just to get that information and figure that out. But you're gonna get it very fast. So anyway, those are the two ways to look at it. Do whatever works best for you. Cost per acquisition goal, this is optional. So your cost per acquisition is how much it costs for someone to actually download. So let's say you get three taps at $1 a piece, so that's $3, and of those three taps, you got one download. So your cost per acquisition, which is cost per download, is $3 because it costs you $3 to get that one download. So you can give Apple a target and then, you know, they'll adjust things to try to hit that target. But then this also could limit, you know, your reach. Like I said, I like to just find out what like the market is for the bids and then go from there on my own. You can try that out if you want to, but it's optional. And then again, start and end date, same thing we talked about before. So search match, if I click on the question mark here, right? Search match uses multiple resources. You can read it if you want. Basically, Apple will automatically match your app based on its metadata, like your keywords and stuff, with certain search terms. Again, you're kind of letting Apple take more control. And this could be a good way to, you know, discover new keywords. But in my situation where I'm very narrow and there's certain keywords I wanna dodge, I turn search match off. But again, if you do have more of a broader topic, again, like a habit tracker app, keep it on. And maybe Apple will point you to some keywords that are successful that you might not have thought about. And to be honest with you, I could probably run an experimental campaign where I keep it on just to see what happens. So again, that's kind of the mindset with search ads is some of your ad budget has to be towards experiments. Because there's no way you're gonna find the good stuff and what works, right? The diamonds in the rough. unless you run a bunch of experiments. So whatever ratio that is for you for ad spend that you want to be super impactful and super efficient, and then a certain amount of ad spend to just experiment and try to discover things. And then here's where you'll spend most of your time probably, and that is adding your keywords. So hit add keywords to an ad group. So Apple will suggest a bunch of keywords for you, and you see these blue dots are popularity. So YouTube Studio is YouTube's like default, you know, backend to see my analytics on my YouTube channel. So that's high popularity. And then you see things like, you know, Creative View is actually on there with one dot popularity. YT Tracker is another app in the space, one dot popularity. So unless you're being super narrow and specific like me, you probably want to go for more higher popularity, right? You want to be in front of more people, more impressions. But you can either hit add all 54 recommendations. You can add, let's say I just want to add YouTube subscribers. That's what I'm really targeting. And I want to add YouTube Studio because I definitely want to show up for that, even though that's very competitive. So as you can see, I'm adding the keywords and then I can adjust my max bid per keyword. That $15 default CPT I put in at the beginning, that was just to get me started, right? No matter what keyword I add, content calendar, you know, subscriber count, it's just going to start at 15. I can tweak that later. Now again, broad match versus exact match is what I explained before. For me, I want to be very specific and exact, and I think that's what you probably should do too. Again, maybe run an experiment using broad match to see what shows up, but for the most part, if you're trying to be very efficient, very targeted with your money, I would go exact match. And make sure you have some with high popularity, because something I've ran into because I am so narrow and niche and using exact match is I'm having trouble spending my $40 a day, right? Like sometimes I'll spend $10, $15, and I'm trying to spend that money. But because I, in my specific scenario for Creative View, am using lower popularity keywords and I'm very targeted, I'm not able to spend the money. So you have to balance that as well. If you're trying to be cheap and you're trying to be super surgical and narrow, you may not be able to spend your ad budget. So again, there's a balance of broad discovery versus super surgical and narrow. All right, so now that you have your keywords, and again, you're gonna want, well, depending on your campaign, right? If you're doing your initial experiment, you're gonna want a ton of keywords because you're trying to gather as much data as possible. If you're doing a more targeted campaign, like one of my campaigns is specifically targeting keywords around YouTube subscribers because I created a custom product page for that. So maybe that's a little less keywords. So depending on your goal for the campaign is how many keywords you have. There's no like right or wrong answer. So we'll hit save just for the example. So four keywords added. Now your audience, reach all eligible users. That's everyone. Or if you want to get a little more narrow, choose your specific audience. And here you can see I can do devices. Maybe I only want iPhone only, iPad only, or both. We'll do both there. Customer types, all users. New users, users of my other apps, like if you have other apps on the App Store, or returning users, right? So you can target a very specific kind if you like. Demographics, of course, gender, age range, if you want to dive into that. Locations, so you can show across all locations, or if you want to target a very specific city or state, you can do that as well. Now, add creative. So this is your App Store page, essentially, right? Your default is going to be whatever your App Store says. So this is Creative View's default iPhone App Store one, or you can do custom. Like I said before, this is what I did with my YouTube subscriber specific campaign. I hit custom and you see I have one custom product page available. You have to create these separately. So I create ad, but now you can see my custom subscriber one that I have here. And you can see the screenshots are a little different. I focus on subscriber widgets, subscriber goals. It's more subscriber focused. I could do way better. This was like a quick down and dirty test that I ran to learn how it works, you know, a bit ago. But yeah, if you're gonna do a targeted campaign, you can really tweak your screenshots to be really focused on the keyword you're going for. I'll go cancel. I don't want that. We're just going to use the default page. Scroll down and then create campaign. I'm not going to hit this because I don't actually want to create the campaign. I don't want to spend money on this test. But you create that campaign and you're up and running. And if I go to my search ads campaign, you see it'll show up here. Like I said, this was my initial experiment. If I click on it, just to give you something to see here. It's on hold, right? I'm done. But you can see if I sort by taps. Yeah, you can see, you know, what keywords, you know, what was their cost per acquisition, their cost per tap. So you can see some of my cost per taps on my most taps, $3.61. YouTube subscribers was a 99 cent cost per tap, $2.40 cost per acquisition. That is why I decided like, oh, that's a good keyword. Let me build a whole campaign around that. And I'm waiting for the results of that. But so you can see again, what kind of cost per taps I'm getting, cost per acquisition. Like I said, this initial one was just me throwing spaghetti at the wall and seeing what stuck. I did high bids on all kinds of keywords because I needed this type of data. I needed to know, hey, what has a good cost per tap? What has a high cost per tap? Let me avoid that one, right? You can't optimize what you don't know. So I would recommend your first search ads campaign be that experiment and spend a decent amount of money because that information is valuable that will help you maximize your money in the future. So you have an app on the App Store that you're trying to drive traffic to make money. So you probably have in-app purchases or subscriptions. And if you built that yourself, man, there's a lot of edge cases you may not have handled. I always recommend letting the pros handle that type of stuff. And that brings me to today's sponsor, Glassfy. Glassfy is a ridiculously flexible app revenue management platform that helps engineering and growth teams generate predictable revenue streams from their apps. Glassfy takes a platform approach with various solutions natively built in, like those subscriptions and in-app purchases I was talking about for iOS, Android, and web. I use them to implement that in CreatorView, my app, and the setup was a breeze. It also has revenue growth tools such as rich analytics, paywalls, and redemption codes so teams can use data to make better decisions to generate revenue all within the Glassfy platform. So whether you're adding revenue to an existing app or replacing your current setup, Glassfy will help engineering and growth teams deliver better on their revenue growth goals.